Throughout this pandemic, Dr. Lietchon, you and I have had many conversations, and the goal really is to eventually be able to live with the virus, with the metrics that you mentioned, and with the discovery of all these new subvariants and the metrics showing that it's really not moving yet because, or at all, we still don't know yet because of these subvariants. Do you think that we are beginning to do just that? That we are at that point wherein we're beginning to live with the virus, Dr. Lietchon?
I think we're right now living with the virus. I was expecting a worst case scenario given that we have two primary vaccines. But I think this could be attributed. My personal view is that because of the last quarter mega vaccination in December, we had around 15 million. And then we were affected by the Omicron surge last January. So we have two immunity, one from the vaccine and one from the
natural immunity.
Around at that time, we were close to around 40,000. And this particular hybrid immunity has carried out this particular null number of cases. But let us not be complacent because based on several studies, the waning immunity will be in about 3 to 6 months after the first booster. So we need to increase our layer of protection so that we can actually generate more gains for the economy. And of course, for the next administration, we can actually do this to, you know, metrics of success to finally ramp up the booster and then proceed to the implementation of universal healthcare. I think ending the pandemic on our end will make us a country that will be more resilient, more responsive, and of course can adjust to the economic demands of the next administration.
Because of all that you mentioned, Dr. Lietchon, do you think it's still premature to talk about the lifting of the public health emergency? And if we do that now, how might that affect the emergency use authorization, for example, the vaccines that we're using?
Right. I think it's too early because the procurement of vaccines, particularly the ones, the third and the fourth dose, we know for, I mean, let's call a spade, the efficacy rate of the mRNA vaccines are actually, of course, better than the previous vaccines that we have ordered. And of course, once you are EUA, then we can have the latitude to order more vaccines. But we can have several options. I don't want to remove the public health alert system, because this would affect the procurement of the vaccines for our country. But at the same time, let us look at other options. The other way, in terms of transition, is to make the mRNA vaccines, which are actually being shifted from EUA to full approval in the United States as early as August of last year. So that when we have the full approval, you can actually shift from the EUA so that we can commercialize it and make it available and more accessible to the private citizens, particularly the economic workforce, who will be the main drivers to speed up the economy. We know for a fact that even for 100 years, 1918 flu pandemic, we have, of course, free vaccination at the government level for the flu and pneumonia. But still, some of the private citizens would have to have the vaccination at the private clinics or the hospitals.
But here
so
you
I
have,
think by
but,
open...
Yeah, but Dr. Lietchon, sorry to cut you there, but here you have a very unique situation where in the workforce, even when you lift the EUA and they're able to purchase on their own, the next problem is, will they have enough disposable income to actually purchase those vaccines for their protection, considering what has been happening to the economy, to their sources of income, not just because of the pandemic, but also because of what is happening in Ukraine and the invasion of Russia and how it has cascaded upon economies like the Philippines, Doctor?
Very good point. What I'm trying to say is that we need to plan for the future because eventually, after 1 year of EUA, usually based on my experience and, of course, on the, right now, based on the experience of the U.S., after 1 year of their registration, they have shifted already to this particular mode of having it available so that a lot of people can have access to that. Because, you know, the bureaucratic system of the government cannot really, you know, deploy the vaccine, so that some business establishments who are willing to spend for the employees can actually do that. Mm. I'm not saying that at this point, Carmina, that we have to do that, but it has to be a work in progress. The other thing, Carmina, is that there should be a timeline for the government to complete the booster, because a goal with the timeline is just a dream. I mean, it should been done long time ago. After the mega vaccination, let's say in December, we could have actually boosted up the population in the next 3 months. But of course, this has been the problem, and that's the reason why we have expiring vaccines. So what I'm trying to say, in the next administration, the first 100 days, I think the marching orders for the Department of Health and all cabinet secretaries is to help all employees, all people. It's not a mandate, but to redefine it to 3 doses and have the vaccines ready for everybody, so that in the next 100 days you have full vaccination, 2 primary and then a first booster, so that you can actually speed up on the other programs of the government. So that's my sentiment, Carmina.
All right.